Everyone, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for joining me. So on today's video, we're going to talk about clips and D-rings. So let's just get straight into it and start drawing. So the first thing we're going to draw is a carabiner clip. Find one online that you like and drag into the image. Now we've done this process quite a few times before, where you use an image as a template of something that you want to draw. From here, you can trace the image. Using your pen tool, follow the shape of the object, ensuring that you follow every dip and change to the line. Ensure you connect the anchor points to make one complete object. Now draw the internal in the same way, following every dip and change to the item. Now select the line and head to your Pathfinder tool. Click the minus from front. This makes a full object with a hole in the middle. Now, using your pen tool, go in and divide this object into pieces. Draw lines over the connection points, ensuring that your lines are overhanging like this. Then start dividing. So to divide, click your Pathfinder tool and then click the divide button. When you divide your object, there'll be these invisible lines here, but I'll show you how to sort this out later. Continue to divide your object until it's finished. Now use your direct selection tool and click the invisible lines. Just hover over the area until it comes up, then select it and press delete on your keyboard. Now using the eclipse tool, I'm drawing the rivets. Fill this in using a gradient on radial. Here I'm filling the clip with a gradient, where I want it a more variation of colour. So I click my swatch tool and drag this out. Now I can drag in other colours to the gradient, pressing G and dragging the white line down to change the direction of your gradient. This takes a bit of experimentation to work out when you drag where your gradient will go. So just try it a few different times and you'll get the hang of it eventually. Now I want to draw the highlights. Here I use my pen tool to draw over every highlight that I want to show, changing the weight of the line so it's thicker. Once you have all your highlights drawn, select them all. Then head to your stroke tool and go to the uniform tab. Click this and you can change the ends of your lines to points. Change the thickness of your line and go to the best width, and change the colour to white. Select your highlights and go to Object, Path and Outline Stroke. I covered this in my previous video. If you haven't seen it, click the link below. Now fill your clip with a colour of your choice. Now for the basic dog clip. It's really easy, just follow the same process as before. All the techniques I'm using here I've covered in my previous videos. This is a really useful clip if you're drawing bags, so it can be your shoulder clasp connection. Okay, so now we're going to draw our D-ring. There's two quick ways to draw these. First, use your type tool and simply type a capital D. Find the best font for the shape you want. Now go to the type tab and click create outlines. You can select your anchor points and amend to your ideal size and fill as desired. Another way is to draw a circle and delete the anchor points you don't need. I added extra points so I can elongate the back. You can amend the curves by using the handles. Now head to Object, Path, and Offset Path. Click Preview so you can see what you're doing, and using the Direction tabs, you can change the amount of the offset. Now select both lines and head to your Pathfinder tool and click minus from front. And that's your D-rings done. Now I know we're all really busy, and if you don't have time to draw these from scratch like I have, no worries, I've got you covered. Head to my Etsy shop and you can download the full document. This includes the clips and the D-rings, the zips and zip heads, along with press snaps, buttons, and cords and aglets. This is a great starter set for any budding designer, and it'll pop your CADs out and make it look more designed into. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hopefully you liked this video. If you've got any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. Please like and subscribe by clicking that beautiful red button. Also, let me know if you've got any ideas of what you'd like me to draw in the future. Please also follow me on social media. Instagram's Anthony James London, there's no H in that Anthony. Follow me on Twitter, which is Anthony Pullin, and check out my Etsy shop, which is Anthony James CAD. Okay then, see you on the next one. Alright, thanks, bye. Tra tra tra. Bye.